Hello everyone. So for today's video, I'm gonna explain everything. So step by step on how are you going to block a porn site using OpenDNS with, of course, the implementation of our router, which is a Mikrotik router. So this is also in relation to my previous video in my YouTube channel, which many of the viewers are requesting for a step-by-step or a guide, a full guide on how they are going to block a porn site in their network. Okay, so first is you're going to have a OpenDNS account. So this is only optional, but I will recommend it to for you to have your OpenDNS account. So in order for you to have your OpenDNS account, so you just have to create an account first. Just go here in this URL, which is OpenDNS account, opendns.com rather. So you can clearly see here the OpenDNS web page. So in my case, I have already created my account, so I'm just going to log in my account. So again, this is the first step to log in your account, your newly created account. Okay, so I'm going to log in my account. Okay, and then I'm going to input my password there. Okay, so after logging in, so you will be prompted here in the dashboard of the OpenDNS. So as you can see here, there are tabs right here: stats, settings, my account, support, tell a friend, and so on. So in order for you to add your network, so all you have to do is to click this one, this add network right here. So just click add network, add new network, and then automatically it will detect your one IP address. So as you can see here, this is my current one IP address, and then you can also see here your one IP address that is being automatically added. Okay, so once you are done, and then just click add this network. So add this network, and then you will be prompted right here. So you'll successfully added a network. So just a few more steps and you're home free. So just give it a friendly name, so any name that you want to put. So in my case, I will name this one as firewall. Okay, so and then is this a dynamic IP address? So if it is dynamic, so just retain this one. But if it is static, so just uncheck this one. So in my case, my ISP is in static mode, so my one IP address is in static. So I will uncheck this one and then click done. Okay, so as you can see, network successfully added. So you can now then customize it on your needs, on depending on what level of security you're going to use. So just click this one. Okay, so in here you can choose the level of filtering that you want to apply it in your network. So if it is on high, so you can also view and customize it. Okay, so on moderate, you can also view and customize. On low, the same thing. And then the custom, of course, you want to customize the level of filtering. Okay, so in this example, I just want to set it into moderate. Okay, so I will click it moderate, and then I will going to customize it. Okay, customize. Okay, so in here you can see here the options that you want to include in your filters, in your filtering. So say for example, academic fraud, adware, auctions, business services, music, photo sharing, radio, search engines, software, technology, television, video sharings, web spam. So I'm just going to add here the web spam so that no spams will be in my emails. And then I just also wanted to block a movies, okay, movies, and then of course the games, if you want to block any games. And then let's see, social networking, if you want to block Facebook or any social media accounts or search engines, you can also block this one. Software technology, if you don't want to download any exe files or softwares, and so on. So you can also disable P2P file sharing, news media, and so you can almost decide on what are you going to include in your filtering and your blocking. Okay, so blogs, you can also block that one, anime, manga. And then after that, so you're going to click this one, apply. So in my case, I will not just click this one because this is our network. So I will not block any of this. But just for this demonstration, that you're going to click this one, apply. So after clicking apply, there will be a prompt here that you're going to wait for 3 minutes in order for the filter or content filter to take effect on your network. Okay, so that's it. So you can always you can also block a specific website right here. So this one, so all you have to do, say for example you're going to block a just sample website, you're going to block YouTube, okay, youtube.com. So all you have to do is to copy the URL and then go to here, so and then add domain. Okay, so once you click this add domain, so automatically the YouTube will be permanently blocked. Okay, so this options right here is for blocking a certain websites. Okay, so you can always, or you can also use this one, this feature. Okay, so if we try to visit a porn site, so I'm just going to add a new tab or open up new incognito tab. So for example, okay, so as you can see, we can still or can open a porn site. Okay, so all you have to do is just to choose a content filtering. So in my case, I'm going just to choose this one, moderate. And if you want to customize, just click this one, the customize, and then click apply. Okay. So I'm going to click apply. Okay. So there will be prompt that you just have to wait for 3 minutes in this one, setting save. So just wait for 3 minutes in order for our content filtering to take effect in our network. Okay, so in order to do that, so you're just going to log into your Mikrotik router. So I'm just going to log into my Mikrotik router. So using inbox, and then I'm going to connect it. So all you have to do is to go to IP and then firewall, and then we're going to, so under the NAT tab, so we're going to add a new DNS, or just click this one, this add button right here. So just click this one, add, and then go to general, and then destination NAT or DST NAT, and then the protocol will be UDP. Okay, so UDP, and then we're going to add a destination port. So destination port will be port 53, and then go to action, and then destination DST NAT. Okay, and then in here we're going to input our open DNS servers. Okay, so we're going to input this one. So right click and then copy. Okay, and then we're going to paste this one in here, and then two ports. Of course, we're going to add port 53, and then just click apply and okay. So this time, even if the user will going to change the DNS in their local router or local computer, so they will be redirected to the DNS server which we set it in our Mikrotik router. So even if they change into Google DNS, so they cannot bypass. So one thing, we're just going to add a DNS in our network. So all you have to do is to go to IP and then DHCP servers, and then in networks, we're going to add this one in our local network. So say for example, this is my local network. So I'm going to add a DNS server, which is open DNS, and then click apply and then okay. Okay, so that's it. So the user now cannot bypass our configured open DNS server. Okay, so 3 minutes is up. So we're now going to check our visit, if we can still visit a porn site. So again, I'm going to open up a new incognito tab. Okay, so we're going to visit a okay, so it's, yes, okay, so it's just load up. Okay, so as you can see, it's not working anymore, so we cannot browse a porn site. Okay, so let's check our anti-DNS bypass if it still works. Okay, so I'm going to just close this one. So in order for us to test our anti-DNS bypass, so I'm going to change my DNS into Google DNS. Okay, so in order for you us to change, so just click this one and then open network internet settings, and then you're going to be prompted in here, and then just click change adapter options. Okay, so I'm going to close this one, and then in here I'm going to click and then click properties, and then I'm going to change my DNS into Google DNS. So let's see if can still, or our open DNS bypass works or is properly working. Okay, so it's ipconfig/all. We're going to check. So as you can see, DNS servers is already Google DNS. So we're going to open up a new incognito tab again, and let's see if we can, if a porn site still blocked. Okay, pornhub.com. Sorry, I mistype it. Pornhub.com. Okay, so it's not working. So that means our anti-DNS bypass is working properly. Okay. So even if we change our DNS in here. So we change it into Google DNS. So still our firewall or our anti-DNS bypass is working properly. Okay, so if you think this video is helpful, so kindly subscribe to my channel, and more tutorials will be coming soon and uploaded soon. So thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.